Calgary Foothills?
Bill 11, Mr. Speaker.
Bill 11, correct.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Today, I rise to speak on Bill 11. The Innovates groups have been brought under one ministry, being the Ministry of Economic Development and Trade. As the shadow minister for the ministry, for this ministry, these four corporations have been on my radar since this ministry was created. I have had the chance to meet with the CEO and soon-to-be previous CEO of the Innovates Alberta Biosolutions, Mr. Steve Price. This meeting was back in February of this year, and he was already aware that the Innovates departments were amalgamating. He was able to provide some of the details, such as the merger of the boards and separation of these Innovates Tech features in a separate subsidiary. During that meeting, I was able to learn a lot about the organization itself. I learned that they examine research proposals and fund those they deem worthy. With more funding from private investors, they have been able to help take research projects to the market. I learned that due to Alberta's large agricultural sector and forests, that many companies come to Alberta for the vast biomass available. Alberta is also one of the leaders of nanotechnology for agriculture and cellulose nanocrystals, otherwise known as wood pulp. It was a very informative meeting, and I was grateful for Mr. Price to take time out of his busy schedule and educate me on what this arm of the Innovates Corporation does. It was always great to know that many of our brilliant Albertan minds are creating new and exciting products, whether through government or private institutions. I was also privy to a tour of Alberta Innovates Tech Features by the CEO, Mr. Stephen Lougheed, back in April. He was also aware of the merger of the Innovates Corporations at that time. I was able to see the prototypes of new technology that may one day help my former petrochemical colleagues in the future. I was able to see their very large facility with very few people working on such a large complex. It was interesting to see why many people wanted to ensure that the funding arm of the Innovates stayed separate from this spending arm. There are many things the past governments did with tax dollars that may have been questionable. Innovates has done some great things in the past, like create many of the technologies used today by our oil field workers. At the beginning of February, I had a very productive meeting with the CEO of Alberta Innovates Energy and Environment Solutions, Mr. Eddie Isaacs. He told me that he was going to retire once the merger happened. He enjoyed his time as the CEO and was able to do many great things with this arm of Innovates. 4 months back, in February, I had a meeting with the Minister for Economic Development and Trade. He was also able to give me some minor details on this merger. He said that Innovates asked to be merged so people would not be confused as to which Innovates Corporation they should be approaching with their research proposals. The meeting did not revolve around that issue, but it was brought up as a question from myself. It was very interesting to hear about this bill from multiple different sources months and months before any public announcement. The very earliest public hint I could find that this merger was happening was in March, when an article came out talking about laying off senior executives in advance of a restructuring for Alberta Innovates. The information gained and compiled from multiple sources leaves me with questions. I do not have all the information, otherwise I would not have questions. Obviously, nothing happens overnight, and there is a lot of work put behind this bill and this merger. Whoever has held a corporate job would understand this aspect. I have, and I understand that there are many working parts that need to continue to operate for a corporation as large as Alberta Innovates to work properly. I understand that many things had to happen before this bill came to the floor. I'm not questioning that many of those things may have had to happen before this bill was presented to the House. For things to run smoothly, I understand that people need to be informed and put in place to ensure a smooth transition. What I'm questioning is the transparency of the entire operation. This government ran on a platform of transparency. Did the government do everything in its power to ensure that this whole process was transparent as possible? Was it possible for the government to be more transparent on this process? Was it possible for this government to release their intentions back when the cabinet agreed to merge the Innovates corporations? When I first heard about this back in January, there was not a speck of information available on this. There was no way to verify if my source was telling the truth. I was happy that the minister did not hide his intentions, and I appreciate his honesty. I'm just curious why this information was not made more readily available to the public sooner. If the minister could answer these questions next time he speaks on this bill, it would be greatly appreciated. I would also like to get clarification on something that was mentioned in one of the meetings. I was told that 50% of the executive positions for the new Innovates Corporation would be filled prior to the CEO being selected. Would the minister be able to answer for me if this is true or not? If it is true, why were those positions filled before the CEO was selected? Should the CEO not have the authority to fill those positions? Will those positions be replaceable? Who is deciding who will fill those positions? Is the minister or his ministry choosing those positions? If so, are those positions going to be patronage positions like the previous government was accused of doing? For the record, I am not accusing this government of doing any of these things. I sincerely do not know the answers to these questions, and that is the purpose of this time. Any and all information would be greatly appreciated. The minister has mentioned the $5 million being given to the Alberta Innovates, which should eat up the $2 million in savings from this merger. So this leads me to questions relating to this savings. We have not received any information as to how this money is being saved. Back in August, the Minister for Economic Development and Trade was looking into managers being paid more than triple the salary of the Premier. Now, if that position was removed, that would be a little over one quarter of the savings. Is the minister saving $2 million by removing four executives or five? We don't know. Mr. Speaker, I want to know where this $2 million worth of savings is coming from and why are the savings not higher? Cutting three-quarters of the boards should save more than $2 million. Can the minister detail for the House or table for the House where the savings are coming from? Can the minister also detail how many board members have been removed and what their costs were so we can do the math ourselves? I believe that if we added those numbers, it would equate to more than $2 million. I know this government likes to jump up and down to be transparent. Hopefully, I'm helping them by showing where their transparency is lacking. I do not mind being proven wrong. What I do mind is not having all the information to make an informed decision on a bill. I appreciate that this government is finally making some effort to find efficiencies. Don't get me wrong, that's a great first baby step on the journey to getting us back to a balanced budget. If the government can find 5,000 more $2 million efficiencies, we can eliminate the $10 billion deficit we are looking at and avoid the $58 billion debt this government will have in 2019. A debt of $58 billion is a huge amount, and I don't think this government realizes how long it will take to pay that debt off, or the toll it will take on Albertans, who will have to pay an extra $2,000 a year just to service that much debt. That's why I want to ensure that this merger of Alberta Innovates is as fiscally effective as possible. And from the minimal information that has been released on this merger, I do not believe this is the case. I do not believe that this merger is being done in a way what is fiscally effective as possible. These are the unanswered questions, Mr. Speaker, that have been brought to my attention. I really hope that this government can answer my questions and provide clarity and more transparency on this merger. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.